Okay, welcome guys. So I'm going to share with you a first impressions on the freshly picked diaper bag, as well as what I am putting in my diaper bag, just to show you how much stuff you can fit inside. So stay tuned if you're into this. If not, you can skip past this baby one, like this baby video. But this is such a cute bag that honestly you could use this as a backpack. You could use it for camping. Like, it's got so much room in there that you could use this if you're just staying overnight somewhere. And I love that it's like super sleek and stylish. So I think it's bomb. Like, I would use this regardless of if I had kids or not. I think it's that cool looking. So let's just get right in. All right, so like I just mentioned, this bag has a ton of space, a ton of pockets. But as I'm transitioning diaper bags, I'm actually gonna try to condense down my life and pack only the essentials, because this bag has gotten unbelievably heavy, and that's not okay. The freshly picked bag is so light to begin with, which is awesome. So you're really not adding like a ton of weight, as long as you don't put too heavy of things inside. Are you gonna be my helper? You wanna be my helper?
Zip this up and zip this up, right?
You gonna do your zipper?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, pull it. Nice. What should we put inside?
I don't know, Mom. We
you don't know?
Maybe we can use an applesauce in there.
Put some applesauce in there? That's a good idea.
Let's put some in there.
So let's go. A little ahead of myself and started putting snacks in. So both bags, what I really like is that they have like these inside side compartments, and that's actually what I like to stick the diapers in, just because they're so deep and then it keeps the diapers away from the middle section. I don't know how great you can see. I'll try to, if I can remember, do some better shots. But Navy's diapers, I like to fit on the sides because it's a little bit more of like a thicker, bigger pocket. And then Indy's diapers, I'll stick in one of the side ones just because it's a little bit more room there. And pardon my cough. I have had a cough for like days. Okay, so wipes. I think I'm going to try to stick them in this part. Zippy pocket.
I can see you.
Can you see me?
Uh-huh.
There's actually this back pocket with the diaper changing pad. That's going to be a great pocket to put wipes in. So I went ahead and did that. And then for Navy, we like to keep a little bag of crayons so that she can do her coloring books. And so, Navy, where should we put the crayons?
I don't know.
In my previous bag, I had them in one of like the front little pockets, but it just goes so deep there. So I think I need to put this. I don't know where I'm gonna put this yet. So I'm gonna take out coloring books, my books. Like, that's why this bag is so stinking heavy, you guys. It's because I'm carrying basically the library, which is absurd. All right. Tons of surprises. Alright, so it looks like we have loads of fruit snacks that I didn't know about. This should be like one of those what's in my bag videos, because that's like what is happening here is literally what is in my bag. Okay, so like immunization cards, I like to keep in the back, like zippy pocket on the inside, just to keep them protected in the spot where I would remember.
And
okay, hand sanitizers. Where should we put those, Navy Bean?
On your bag.
Should we put them in this pocket too? So hand.
Okay, so applesauce.
I like to have a little pocket for snacks as well. So I think, I'm trying to decide what's gonna be the best one. Maybe I'll put like little notebooks, because she loves to draw in little notebooks in this front little pocket. Snacks will go in one of these little front pockets. And I'll put pictures for you guys too. That way she gets them. All right, so I actually decided to take the crayons and put them in a a little zip pouch. This will help keep them contained, and then they look cuter. And then that way they can kind of just be at the bottom of the bag. And then rather than take all these books, I'm just gonna take two and take one coloring book. That way we don't have too many books in here, taking up a ton of space. And then pack formula for Indy. And this I'll just set at the bottom as well. And actually, okay, you guys are gonna think I'm crazy. So I swapped out the books with where the wipes and the diaper changing pad were. So I'll take a picture. You can take a look at the organization just a little bit more. We have all these little books. These ones are light, so we'll pack those as well. Just a couple more coloring book options. And then we like to have a little burp rag for Indy. So I'm just gonna roll that up, put that at the bottom of the bag as well. And then I think we're basically good. I'm just gonna pop my wallet in here. It's just gonna chill on top of the snacks, I guess. Actually, my wallet could even go in this little front section. That way, if I'm out and about, it's easier to get to. Ugh, I do not like that. I don't know about you guys, but I like things to just stay smooth. So I'm not putting anything at all in that front section. I actually took out the little mini notebooks. I just don't, my wallet has bumps and I don't want to like make the leather bumpy. So gotta move my wallet. Like, I'm kind of frustrated because honestly, this is why I wanted a new diaper bag, is because I felt like my old one was not doing the job. But honestly, it has all the exact same pockets that this one has. And like, I am impressed. It is really organized and it looks pretty, like on the outside and the inside. But I'm kind of like a little kid that doesn't like my food touching. It's like, I have to have everything in a place, and I just go really crazy if things are not perfect, which is so nuts. I'm really trying to get out of this weird habit, and I'm trying to be like more open with stuff, but like, this is really kind of giving me anxiety, which is so silly because I'm like, why? I got a ton of junk out and I'm just carrying basically the essentials. So let's just try, I'll try closing this. So what's really neat too is on the outside, if you needed it to be wider, you could leave it like open like this, or you could actually take it and it will snap to create more of a slanted triangle side rather than like a square pointy side. Okay, so with Indy's bottles, if I was to put one here on the side. It does fit. And then if I needed a water bottle for myself or a water bottle for Navy, it'd probably be about this size. And okay, it's it's not sliding in as much as I would have liked it to. Because of the bag that I put on the inside of the pocket. Yeah, I don't like that. So the pocket doesn't fit as well as I would have liked it to once you have stuff inside the bag. And feeling it is quite heavy. And so that bugs me too. And I know I have two children and I just need to get over it. But like, I'm actually kind of disappointed. And for almost $200. Sorry, I got interrupted by someone at the door. So just to be realistic, I brought a toy for Indy. We're gonna set that in there as well because she likes to play with toys. And then here's a spare outfit for her as well because you have blowouts, that's a thing. So putting that in there as well. I keep saying as well and that is so annoying. So here is Navy's water bottle. I'm gonna put that on the opposite side than that silly little crayon bag because that is annoying as heck. I know it's like meant to bulge out, but you guys, I'm talking about the anal thing. It bugs me. I don't like that. So I would not put Indy's bottle on the outside. Her bottle would have to end up being stored on the inside. And then let me take a quick picture about what this looks like for you guys. Thing is though, you can wear it like a little backpack, or it does come with a crisscross strap, and then you can actually detach here and then hide these straps in this back pocket, which I thought was really, really cool. It's a really difficult pocket to get into though, now that I've filled my bag. I might have to edit through some things and clear it out more because I can tell that this is just going to really weigh down, and I just don't know if it's strong enough for how heavy this is. So anyways, whew, that is my first impressions as well as what I like to keep in my diaper bag. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this was like insightful in some way, and maybe you either want to get this bag or maybe you don't anymore, but I just thought I'd put the review out there for you guys, and if I don't return it, then I'll let you know how it goes as I use it in the future. So, thank you guys for watching. You're amazing, and I'll see you next time.